With me this morning from First Graphene is Mike Bell. Mike, good morning.
Good morning. Great to speak again, Andrew.
Good to see you, Mike. Look, an update recently from you on the June quarter. This, of course, being your fourth quarter and a strong period for you. Give us an overview.
Yeah, so Q4 wrapped up the end of June, which is the end of our financial year 22. So the quarter was our strongest quarter by far to date, which is exciting. We wrapped up at about 360K revenue for the quarter, which gives us a total annual revenue of just under $750,000. Now, we're obviously working off a modest base, but that's over 100% revenue growth on our previous financial year. So really, really positive results, obviously unaudited numbers there. What it does do is it demonstrates that our traction in those targeted segments is starting to move. Our go-to-market strategies is working, and the use of our industry experts as commercial managers is starting to pay off and make that difference.
Remind us of the core markets that you've been targeting.
Yeah, so we traditionally had five markets, which was cement and concrete, composites and plastics, rubbers, elastomers, coatings and inks, and energy storage. And we have had a change to that in the last period, in which we've merged our rubbers, elastomers, and coatings and inks segments into a more industry standard case, which is coatings, adhesive, sealants, and elastomers. That's led by Peter Osborne out of the UK, and it gives a sort of much better fit in terms of internal skill sets, but also sort of the technologies across those segments that are very similar. So a better use of people.
And what are your expectations looking ahead full year 23? What are your priorities? What are you working on?
So when we look back at the 22 year, the bulk of our revenue came from a few early adopter clients, which is in the composites and plastic space. So that's solar thermal roof tiles, and we're now moving that into a production material, swimming pools, marine applications, and a large number of sort of early stage trials of our recently released master batch products. We started to get a bit of traction in the cement and concrete space in the fourth quarter, which is the start of what I see as a bit of a trend as we go into financial year 23. We've continued work in the liquid grinding aid space for the manufacture of cement. We've also recently launched a liquid concrete admixture. So that basically gives the benefits of graphene into concrete. So that's been launched through a partner of ours in South Africa. And also just ongoing development work with our industry partners. So that's starting to get traction. Our case segment, we're starting to get a much larger number of interested parties, typically smaller opportunity size, but a lot larger number. And so this is things like sporting textiles, anti-static flooring, fire retardancy applications, etc. We look into financial year 23 with about sort of $175,000 worth of orders that are placed with us that we just need to deliver on. And we've got a number of those cement and concrete related purchase orders in the pipe, which are really exciting. They are a different scale of product for us. So that's really positive. We've recently signed a JDA, Joint Development Agreement, with Greatcell Energy in Australia, who are doing some really exciting stuff in perovskite solar cells. So that's creating quite a bit of buzz in our R&D team. That adds into our energy storage segment, where we're still progressing supercapacitor materials and our KNOS process. So that's all progressing in the sort of right realm.
I suppose, Mike, just finally, given the growth, what's your view on First Graphene's valuation? And why should investors take a look at the company now?
That's a good question. The overall valuation where we're at today, you know, we have, as a company across the global markets, everybody has had a really tough 6 months, and we are no exception. What we are doing is we're putting our heads down and focusing on that revenue generation. And that's where I believe that'll make a valuation difference and drive it up. You know, we've even seen, you know, a slight uptick in valuation just from our Q4 results, which is great because it shows that people can understand what we're up to. And the outlook on that with cement and concrete, with a number of these applications that are moving from sort of production trials into production over the next 6 to 12 months, it's only going to continue in terms of growth. So as an outlook, I'm pretty excited about it. And I think we can sort of put the last 3 to 6 months behind us. You know, globally, it's been a very, very tough market. We've still got some unknowns ahead of us with the war in the Ukraine, unrest in Sri Lanka. You know, there's so many factors, including, you know, inflation, et cetera, that will all play a factor. But I'm positive about that outlook and look forward to the new financial year.
Good to speak, Mike. Thanks very much.
You too. Thank you so much.